Dear students, today's topic is DC and AC circuit breaker. This topic is very useful for electrical engineering students. If you want to more videos like this, so share and subscribe this video. I am Rakesh Singh Lodhi, working as assistant professor in Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering. How is DC braking done? The contacts of the DC breaker separate and the arc is transferred from contacts to the runners, where it rises upwards and extinguishes on its own. Drawbacks of HVDC circuit breaking. The amount of energy to be dissipated during the short interval of braking is very high as compared to the conventional AC circuit breakers. The natural zero current does not occur as in the case of AC circuit breaker, resistance switching and the efficient cooling by forcing the liquid or air blast are used to dissipate the high amount of energy. This is a simple DC circuit given here. Here R is a resistance, L is inductance, E is a battery. An inductive DC circuit is shown here. Here capital B shows the circuit breaker is connected in the circuit, and EB is the voltage. Assuming B breaks the current I, it means I is equals to E upon R. This is the arc characteristics. It means the graph between I and E. It means current and voltage. Here you see the different breaker voltage and different current. The differential equation of the circuit. The circuit which is seen slide, E is equals to L di by dt plus R into I plus EB. So we can determine L di by dt is equals to E minus RI minus EB into I is equals to del E. Basically it represents the function of current. So if del E is negative, then it means current will decrease. If del E is positive, that means increase the current. Basic requirement. Progressive lengthening of arc is a basic requirement of DC circuit breakers. In designing an HVDC circuit breaker, there are main problems to be solved. The problem number one, how to produce a current zero, how to prevent restriking, how to dissipate the stored energy. If you want to know about the restriking, there is another video in which I define what is restriking. Producing current zero, the point number one. This approach involves changing the form of arc current by commutation principle. Quenching gear of well proven HVAC circuit breaker. Principle of oscillatory circuit. Prevention of restrikes. To produce a good ionizing arc, the space between two balls of arc chute can be narrowed to restrict the arc. At the same time, it can be broken into number of arcs by inserting a grating of vertical metal plane. Dissipation of stored energy. A protective spark gap can be used across the circuit breaker to reduce the size of the commuting capacitor. It will keep the abnormal voltage produced at the switching time below the undesired level. By means of high frequency currents, the spark gap acts as an energy dissipating device. Interruption of capacitive current. It is another topic. If you want to know this topic, you just like, share and subscribe. It means the click the bell icon. Interruption of capacitive current. Effect. The interruption of capacitive current produces high voltage transients across the gap of the circuit breaker. When this occurs, when an unloaded long transmission line or a capacitor bank is switched off. Only this is the reason interruption of capacitive current. This is the electrical circuit. It represents the simple power system. E is a source and L is inductance, C is capacitance and V and the voltage across the switch, that is VR. The voltage across capacitor is VCL and CL shows the capacitance. This is just a simple circuit you already studied in the network analysis and in the basic power system also. Considering an electrical circuit of a simple power system, just I will describe some points related to this circuit. Stray capacitance of the circuit breaker, that is C. CL, that is the capacitance of the line. Transient voltage across the gap of the circuit breaker when the capacitive current is interrupted. This is just a waveform. According to this waveform, you just easily understand about the transient voltage across the gap of the circuit breaker. At the instant M, according to the waveform, the capacitive current is zero, system voltage is maximum. If interruption occurs, capacitor CL remains charged at the maximum value of system voltage. After the instant M, voltage across the breaker gap is the difference of VC and VCL. You see in the figure. At the instant N, the voltage across the gap is twice the maximum value of VC. If the breaker restrikes, the voltage across the gap becomes partially zero. Voltage falls from 2 VC max to zero. A severe high frequency oscillation occurs about the point S. Interrupted again, if restriking current is zero, the capacitor CL at the voltage negative 3 emax at the instant P. The system voltage reaches its positive maximum at point T. Voltage across the gap becomes 4 times of emax. The capacitive current reaches zero again and there may be an interruption. The transient voltage oscillates between negative 3 emax and positive 5 emax point P to Q. Thus voltage across the gap goes on increasing. These all points are already described in the waveform. You just reverse this presentation, then you see all the point. Types of circuit breakers. There are many types of circuit breaker, but here I will describe oil circuit breakers, vacuum circuit breakers, air blast circuit breakers, SF6 circuit breakers. Number 1, oil circuit breaker. It is designed for 11 kV to 765 kV. It means oil circuit breaker is designed for 11,000 volt to 765,000 volt. There are two types. Number 1, BOCB, it means bulk oil circuit breaker. Another one is MOCB, that means minimum oil circuit breaker. You see in the figure, the contacts are immersed in oil bath. Oil provides cooling by hydrogen created by arc. It acts as a good dielectric medium and quenches the arc. You just see in the figure, there are parts of the oil circuit breakers like drain valve, operating rod, supporting chamber, arc extinction device, circuit breaker chamber, breather, top chamber, gas vent, fixed contact, moving contact, glass fiber enclosure. Advantage and disadvantage. Advantage first. Oil has good dielectric strength, low cost. It means oil circuit breaker is cheap. Oil is easily available. It has wide range of breaking capability. Disadvantages. Slower operation. It takes about 20 cycles for arc quenching. It is highly inflammable, so high risk of fire. High maintenance cost. The second circuit breaker is vacuum circuit breaker. It is designed for medium voltage range, 3.3 kV. It means 3300 volt to 33 kilovolt. It means 33,000 volt. This consists of vacuum, of pressure. What is the value of vacuum of pressure? 1 cross 10 to the power minus 6. Inside arc extinction chamber. The arc burns in metal vapor when the contacts are disconnected. At high voltage, its rate of dielectric strength recovery is very high. Due to vacuum, arc extinction is very fast. The contacts lose metals gradually due to formation of metal vapors. You see in this diagram, it is a representation of vacuum interrupter chamber in vacuum circuit breaker. There are the advantage and disadvantages of vacuum circuit breaker. Number one, free from arc and fire hazards. This is very important advantage. Low cost for maintenance and simpler mechanism. Low arcing time and high contact life. Silent and less vibrational operation. Due to vacuum, contacts remain free from corrosion. No byproducts formed. Disadvantages: high initial cost due to creation of vacuum. Surface of contacts are depleted due to metal vapors. High cost and size required for high voltage breakers. The third type of circuit breaker is air blast circuit breaker. This operates using high velocity blast of air which quenches the arc. It consists of blast valve, blast tube and contacts. Blast valve contains air at high pressure. Blast tube carries the air at high pressure and opens the moving contact attached to spring. There is no carbonization of surface as in vacuum circuit breaker. Air should be kept clean and dry to operate it properly. This is the diagram of that type of circuit breaker. You see in the below side, what are the parts? There is a name of parts are given, like air receiver, valve, hollow insulator, fixed contact, moving contact, piston, spring, exhaust valve, isomaker, operating mechanism. You just see this circuit breaker and the parts of this circuit breaker. And advantages: high speed operation as compared to oil circuit breaker. Ability to withstand frequent switching. Facility for high speed reclosure. Less maintenance as compared to oil circuit breaker. There are some disadvantages also. Little moisture content prolongs arcing time. Pressure should be checked frequently for frequent operation. Risk of fire hazards due to overvoltages. It can't be used for high voltage operation due to prolonged arc quenching. Another type of circuit breaker is SF6 circuit breaker. It contains an arc interruption chamber containing SF6 gas. Do you know what is the full form of SF6? Can you write in the comment? In closed position, the contacts remain surrounded by SF6 gas at a pressure of 2.8 kg per centimeter square. During opening, high pressure SF6 gas at 14 kg per centimeter square from its reservoir flows towards the chamber by valve mechanism. SF6 rapidly absorbs the free electrons in the arc path to form immobile negative ions to build up high dielectric strength. It also cools arc and extinguishes it. After operation, the bulb is closed by the action of a set of springs. Absorbent materials are used to absorb the byproducts and moisture. SF6 is sulfur hexafluoride. This is the full form of SF6. This is the diagram of SF6 gas. It shows arc extinction in gas flow circuit breaker. In the yellow color you see nozzle, and in the red color you see the fixed contact. The advantages: very short arcing period due to superior arc quenching property of SF6, can interrupt much larger currents as compared to other breakers, no risk of fire, low maintenance, light foundation, no overvoltage problem, there are no carbon deposits. There are some disadvantages also. Number one, SF6 breakers can costly due to high cost of SF6 because the sulfur hexafluoride gas is too much costly. SF6 gas has to be reconditioned after every operation of the breaker. Additional equipment is required for this purpose. Comparison of circuit breaker, because we are already studied all types of circuit breaker, so there is a comparison between the oil circuit breakers, air circuit breakers and vacuum or SF6 circuit breaker, because there is some similarities between the vacuum and SF6 circuit breaker. So the factor number one, safety, risk of explosion and fire due to increase in pressure during multiple operations. But in air circuit breakers, emission of hot air and ionized gas to the surroundings. But in vacuum or SF6 circuit breaker, no risk of explosion. Next factor is size. Oil circuit breaker is quite large, air circuit breaker is medium, but vacuum or SF6 circuit breaker is smaller. Next factor is maintenance. Regular oil replacement in the oil breakers, replacement of arcing contacts in air circuit breakers, minimum lubrication for control devices in vacuum or SF6 circuit breakers. Another factor is environmental factor, because this is very important. Oil breakers and air breakers, environmental factors are the same. It means humidity and dust in the atmosphere can change the internal properties and affect the dielectric. But in the vacuum and SF6 circuit breaker, no effect due to environment. Next factor is endurance. In oil circuit breaker, below average. In air circuit breaker, average. But in vacuum or SF6 circuit breaker, excellent endurance. So you easily understand the comparison of each circuit breaker. Thank you for listening. If you want to this type of videos more, then you just like, share and subscribe.